Hello everyone, welcome to this session on the functional components of cranial nerve nuclei. This is one of the topics which students find it most difficult in neuroanatomy, so I've decided to take up this topic for you all. So in this session we'll be covering all the functional components. So which all are the functional components? Here we can see the list. There are three motor columns and there are four sensory columns. So all these functional components we'll be covering in this particular session. Before beginning with the functional components, a little knowledge about the embryology is essential. So we'll see that. So during the development of the brain and the spinal cord, in the neural tube, we can see there is a longitudinal groove which is referred to as sulcus limitans. Okay, here we can see there is a development of spinal cord, and this marked structure, this is the sulcus limitans, which divides the lateral wall of the neural tube into a dorsal alar lamina and a ventral basal lamina. Okay, so this is a basal lamina and this is the alar lamina. Basal lamina is motor, which will have motor nuclei, and alar lamina is sensory, will be having sensory nuclei. Okay, so this is in the neural tube and this is in the region of spinal cord. Okay, and when we see in the region of the brain stem, this neural tube opens up like this on each side. Okay, it will open up in this way so that the alar lamina which is seen, it is deviated to the lateral aspect. Here we can see this is the alar lamina and basal lamina is on the medial aspect. This is in the region of the brain stem. Here we can see the cavity of the fourth ventricle, and here this structure is the sulcus limitans. When we study the floor of the fourth ventricle, there is a structure which is referred to as sulcus limitans, medial to which there is a basal lamina which contains of motor nuclei, and lateral to it there are sensory nuclei. Okay, so this basic knowledge is important before studying the functional components, and we should be knowing about the various difference between the functional components in spinal cord and functional components in brain stem. We all know there are in all 7 functional components, but in spinal cord there are 4 functional components. Okay, there are some additional functional components in brain stem. So here we can see the functional components of the spinal cord. In spinal cord, all functional components are general. Okay, all 4 components are general, whereas in brain stem, few additional special functional components are added up, and that's how it becomes 7 in number. So 4 general are general somatic afferent, general visceral afferent, general somatic efferent, and general visceral efferent. Okay, these 4 are the components in spinal cord. There are some additional special components which are added on in the brain stem, and that's how it becomes 7 in number. 2 special components we can see: special visceral efferent. So here we can see general somatic efferent and general visceral efferent. In between them, there will be a component special visceral efferent. Similarly, here there will be a component special visceral afferent. Okay. And there is one more special component which is on the lateral most part. This is referred to as the special somatic afferent. So these are all the 7 functional components in the brain stem. Okay, and the 4 functional components are in the spinal cord. Now let's explore each functional component one by one. So motor components, as we all know, there are 3 in number. So I've listed down all the 3. So depending upon the name of the functional component, we can derive what is the function of that component. So whenever there is a component which is referred to as special visceral efferent, it refers to the muscles of the pharyngeal arches. As you all know, the pharyngeal arches have got separate nerves. The nerve of the first arch is mandibular nerve, that's the branch from the trigeminal nerve. Then 7th nerve, facial nerve, is the nerve of the second arch. Glossopharyngeal nerve, nerve of the third arch. And nerve of 4th and 6th arch together is the vagus nerve. Okay, 4th and 6th arch together, the nerve is vagus nerve. 4th arch is superior laryngeal nerve, 6th arch is recurrent laryngeal nerve. So all the muscles supplied by these nerves will have the component special visceral efferent. So there's one keyword for special visceral efferent, that is pharyngeal arches. Then general visceral efferent. Just appreciate the name. General visceral efferent. This refers to the supply to the parasympathetic supply to the smooth muscles and the glands of the body. The parasympathetic supply is also referred to as the craniosacral outflow. The cranial is formed by the 3, 7, 9 and the 10th cranial nerves. Okay. 3, 7, 9, 10, they form the cranial parasympathetic outflow, and those are included in general visceral efferent column. All the glands, the submandibular gland, sublingual, parotid, and glands in the GI tract, glands in the respiratory tract, all will be supplied by this component, general visceral efferent component. Okay. Then general somatic efferent means, soma refers to the body wall. So muscles which are derived from the somites, those will be supplied by the general somatic efferent component. So in the head and neck region, there is extraocular muscles and tongue muscles. Extraocular muscles, those are supplied by the 3rd, 4th and the 6th cranial nerve, and tongue muscles are supplied by the 12th cranial nerve, hypoglossal nerve. Okay. So these nerves will have this functional component, general somatic efferent component. So this was just a basic idea of the motor or the efferent columns. Now let's see the sensory or the afferent columns. So sensory columns are 4 in number. First, I have listed down special visceral afferent. Special visceral afferent refers to the taste sensations. Taste is a special sensation. So taste sensations are carried by the 7th nerve, 9th nerve, 10th nerve. Okay. Then general visceral afferent, this refers to the general sensations. So what do you mean by general sensations? Pain, touch, temperature. Okay. All these are included in general sensations. Just for an example, if you are having a coffee, the temperature of that coffee is a general sensation, but the taste of the coffee is a special sensation. Okay. So general visceral afferent is general sensations from the viscera. In general somatic afferent, general sensations from the body wall. The pain, touch, temperature sensations from the outer aspect of the body. If you see the head and neck region, the trigeminal nerve, the 5th cranial nerve, has got this component, general somatic afferent component. Okay. There are other nerves as well, but this is the major nerve having general somatic afferent component. And special somatic afferent, this refers to the special sensations from the body wall. What do we understand by special sensations from the body wall? The sensations from the ear, the auditory sensations, those are included in special somatic afferent. Also olfactory and optic are included here. Okay. In this image, we can learn about the various location of the nuclei of the functional components. So all those nuclei which we learned now are listed here. These are the motor nuclei and these are the sensory nuclei. Okay. In motor, GSE. GSE was muscles derived from the somites. So 3rd, 4th, and the 6th cranial nerve, they supply the extraocular muscles. And the 12th cranial nerve supplies the tongue muscles. Okay. Then SVE was for the pharyngeal arches. Now the pharyngeal arches are 5th nerve, 7th nerve, 9th and the 10th nerve. Okay. The 11th cranial accessory nerve also joins with the 10th nerve. That's why it is included here. This is the muscles derived from the pharyngeal arches. And GVE, this is the cranial parasympathetic outflow. Cranial nerves 3, 7, 9, 10, which supply the glands and the smooth muscles in the body. Okay. In salivatory nucleus, there are two salivatory nucleus. There is superior salivatory nucleus and inferior salivatory nucleus. And they have shown 3 here because they have shown one lacrimatory nucleus as well. Lacrimatory nucleus is a part of superior salivatory nucleus. So third now, 7th, 9th, and 10th. These cranial nerves are included in GVE column. Then coming to the afferent columns, this these two columns, special visceral afferent and general visceral afferent, they have only a common nuclei, and that's why the name of the nucleus is referred to as nucleus of tractus solitarius. Okay, the cranialmost part of this nuclei receives the special sensations, SVA. The taste sensations are perceived by the cranialmost part of this nucleus of tractus solitarius, as the remaining part will receive the general visceral afferent, that is the pain touch temperature from the viscera. Then general somatic afferent, I told you the fifth nerve or the trigeminal nerve is the major nerve which carries this general somatic afferent fibers, and here we can appreciate the size of this trigeminal nucleus. It occupies the midbrain as well, it occupies the pons as well as it occupies the medulla oblongata, and some part also extends in the spinal cord. Okay, so it is the largest of all the cranial nerve nuclei, and it has got three components. There's a mesenchymalic nucleus, there's a chief sensory nucleus, there's a spinal nucleus of trigeminal nerve. Since there are three components, it will be having three different functions as well. The mesenchymalic nucleus is responsible for proprioception, the chief sensory nucleus is responsible for the touch, tactile sensation, and spinal nucleus is responsible for pain and temperature. Okay, and in special somatic afferent, there is the vestibular nuclei, vestibular and the cochlear nuclei are included in special somatic afferent. Okay, so this is just a summary of all the cranial nerves with their functional components. We'll quickly try to revise it. Olfactory, optic, and the vestibular cochlear nerve, these three have same functional component, special somatic afferent. Okay, oculomotor nerve has got general somatic efferent as well as general visceral efferent. Trochlear nerve only general somatic efferent, supplying the extraocular muscle. And trigeminal nerve has got two functional components, general somatic afferent and special visceral efferent. Whenever special visceral efferent is there, that means pharyngeal arches. Okay, muscles derived from the pharyngeal arches will be supplied by this component. Then facial nerve, glossopharyngeal nerve, and vagus nerve. The functional components looks extensive, but if you try to logically remember, we can see the glossopharyngeal nerve and vagus nerve have got almost same functional components, except the vagus nerve has got one component extra, that is the general somatic afferent, because it carries some sensations from near the ear. Okay, special visceral efferent refers to the pharyngeal arch, GVE refers to the glands and muscles of the GI tract as well as the respiratory tract, and special visceral afferent, whenever special visceral afferent is there, that means it refers to the taste sensations. And general visceral afferent is pain, temperature, and all. Okay, so depending upon the area of supply of the nerve, we can determine the various functional components. Let's see the facial nerve. Facial nerve, special visceral efferent because it is supplying muscles of the pharyngeal arches, GVE because it supplies the glands, the submandibular gland, sublingual gland, lacrimal gland. Okay, special visceral afferent because taste sensation from the anterior two-thirds of the tongue. Then general somatic afferent, certain sensations from the skin around the ear is carried by facial nerve. Okay, then accessory nerve. Accessory nerve has got two components, cranial accessory and spinal accessory. Cranial accessory has got this component, special visceral efferent, and spinal accessory has got this component, general somatic efferent. Hypoglossal nerve has got only one component, GSE, that will supply muscles to the tongue. So this was all about the functional components of the cranial nerve nuclei. So I've tried to concise the topic so that the basic concepts of the cranial nerve nuclei becomes clear to you all. Okay, so if you all have any doubts, you all can ask in the comments section below. Okay, thank you.